The date was May 4th, 1864. The day before, marching with a strength of over 118,000 soldiers, the Army of the Potomac crossed the Rapidan River in the middle of Virginia. The Blue Ridge Mountains lay to the west. To the east lay miles of dark forests and the Confederate Army under command of Robert E. Lee. General Lee had roughly 60,000 men under his command, half as many as the Union Army, but they were ready to put up a strong fight. The Union Army was commanded by Ulysses S. Grant. He was no stranger to battle. He had served in the Army for over 25 years, starting when he was just 17 years old. This was just like Robert E. Lee. The Civil War was not his first war either. Like the Confederate general Robert E. Lee, General Grant had fought in another war. General Ulysses S. Grant leaned against a post outside his tent. The word post in this sentence means a piece of wood or metal that is set into the ground in an upright position. He wearily watched as a long line of supply wagons carrying ammunition, food, and medical supplies rumbled past. The word ammunition refers to the bullets, cannonballs, and other things that are shot out of weapons. These supply wagons made up the rear or backside of the army. The main body of the army, the soldiers who needed all those supplies in order to fight, were miles ahead, deep in the forest, looking for the enemy. General Grant was now the general-in-chief of the entire Union Army. The only person who ranked higher than General Grant was President Lincoln. Grant took his orders from Lincoln, and everyone else took their orders from Grant. Every general in the war faced hard choices and had heavy responsibilities with the lives of thousands of soldiers in his hands. But in 1864, no general had more worries than General Grant. General Grant had spent the first 3 years of the Civil War fighting farther west, away from the action in Virginia. His most impressive victory in the early years of the war came at Vicksburg, a city in Mississippi. The same day that the Union Army had won the Battle of Gettysburg, General Grant won the Battle of Vicksburg after 2 long, hard months. The victory gave the Union final control over the entire Mississippi River, which in turn would make it easier for the Union to take over the rest of the South. The Mississippi River was important because the Union could use it to send troops and supplies from the North to the South. It was easier to use a river to do this because there were no cars or trucks yet, and so there were no highways like we have today. To win the Civil War, the Union needed to take control of the South, including all of its cities and roads. Nobody in the North expected this to be so difficult. The Union had more than 1 million men in uniform. By the end of the Civil War, 1 out of every 10 Union soldiers was African American, and 1 out of 4 Union sailors was African American. Late in the war, the U.S. Congress passed a bill that gave equal pay to the African American soldiers who valiantly fought to help save the Union and bring freedom from slavery. Factories in the North had been working day and night for years, producing weapons, uniforms, blankets, food rations, wagons, and all of the other things the Army needed. Rations are the amounts of food and other materials set aside for each person. The Yankees, as the Union soldiers were nicknamed, had everything they needed to fight and win the war. The Confederates, or rebels as they were often called, did not have as many men as the Union. The South did not have many factories. Many of those it did have early in the war had been destroyed or captured by 1864. Confederate soldiers marched to battle without shoes, without enough food, and sometimes without enough ammunition. Yet, even though they were exhausted and starved, the Confederates somehow held on and managed to keep fighting. Grant was not the general-in-chief of the Union Army or commander of all the U.S. armies at the beginning of the Civil War. Throughout the war, President Lincoln had trouble with some of his top Union generals. It wasn't that they were bad generals. They could win battles and capture enemy forts and towns, but they made mistakes as well. They often waited too long to attack or failed to chase the Confederates when they were on the run. Basically, President Lincoln felt the Union generals were never aggressive or forceful enough. But Grant was different. General Grant had won the long Battle of Vicksburg because he was stubborn and unafraid. He kept fighting and attacking until the enemy surrendered or gave up. President Lincoln put General Grant in charge of the entire Union army because General Grant promised that he would do whatever it took to win. He would chase General Robert E. Lee and his army all over Virginia, and he would not stop until the war was finished. This outlook earned him the nickname Unconditional Surrender, because he would accept nothing less from the Confederate Army than a complete surrender. General Grant removed a folded letter from his breast pocket. President Lincoln had sent this letter a few days earlier. It did not contain any vital or necessary information or new orders. It was just a simple letter sent to wish him good luck in battle. Grant reread the letter, written in the president's own handwriting. Lieutenant General Grant, not expecting to see you again before you march into Virginia. I wish to tell you that I am entirely satisfied, or I am entirely happy, with what you have done up to this time. You are alert and self-reliant, and pleased with this, I do not wish to control your actions in any way. If there is anything wanting which is within my power to give, do not fail to let me know it. And now, with a brave army and a just cause, a worthy cause, may God sustain you or keep you strong. Yours very truly, A. Lincoln. The next day, May 5th, in the forests near Fredericksburg, Virginia, the main body of Grant's army clashed with General Lee's army in one of the wildest battles of the war. In those days, armies always preferred to fight in open fields where it was easier to move cannons and large groups of men, and easier for generals to see what was happening. This time, though, the armies met deep in the woods, where the tree and plant growth was so heavy that the soldiers could barely see one another. This was called the Battle of the Wilderness, and it was the very first time Generals Grant and Lee faced each other in battle. It was a very chaotic battle. Thousands were killed and wounded. At the end of the day, both armies limped away with no clear winner of the battle. After the battle, many of the Union wounded were taken to churches and homes in the nearby city of Fredericksburg. Clara Barton was there in one of those churches, tending to wounded soldiers. The next day, hundreds more wounded soldiers were brought in from yet another battle, and on it went. The armies of Grant and Lee met again and again during the months that followed. Sometimes Grant won the battle, sometimes Lee won, and sometimes nobody won. But with each battle, the Confederate army got a little smaller and that much closer to final defeat.